Hello. Nice to see you again.
You as well. What can I help you with?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? It's good luck for me. You stopped. Glad you were able to stop by.
It must lead to something grand.
Excuse me, madam. I thought I heard you say something.
Yes, indeed. Talking to myself again, I find myself to be quite the engaging conversationalist since my husband passed. Madam Althea Twiddle, pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Madam Twiddle.
You know, you might be interested in this. You young people love this sort of thing. My husband often ruminated on the mysterious statue just outside our hamlet. Some sort of archaic puzzle involving vases, he would insist. I stumbled upon it today when I had a burst of energy and extended my morning constitutional a bit longer than usual.
An archaic puzzle? Sounds fascinating.
You see, I suspected you'd be interested, and wait till I tell you about the rumours surrounding this particular puzzle. My husband Greville insisted that solving the puzzle would reveal a magical challenge of sorts. The man was intrigued by everything. He was about to try and solve it himself when... Perhaps you could take a look. I'd be rather interested to hear what, if anything, you find.
Where can I find this statue?
It's not far from Irondale. It's down by the shore, near those old ruins. You can't miss it.
If I happen to see it, I'll have a look.
Ah, the spirit of youth. I do hope you'll be able to solve the puzzle. If not for me, then in Greville's memory.
I should look into the statue Madam Twiddle mentioned.
Don't get me started on how difficult
it is to find. I know what that means. Merlin trial.
Expelliarmus! Confringo!
Not so tricky after all, Merlin. I wonder if I'm safe to explore in there. This looks like the statue Madame Twiddle mentioned. Why are there so many vases around here?
Let me also.
I suppose I should try to find all the vases. I think there should only be a few more vases.
Incendio. Confringo.
I'm nearly finished. One more vase.
Revelio.
Oi, pass that fire whiskey over.
Accio. Wingardium Leviosa.
Hello. Do you have anything for sale?
Hello. It's not often I see Hogwarts students here during the school year. I'm Priya Treadwell, at your service, and I sell a variety of travelling necessities.
Are you related to Nora Treadwell?
Why, yes. She's my wife. Brilliant historian. Did you know that she's pursuing Merlin's life's work?
I actually met her and she introduced me to her work. I'm involved in it now as well.
Oh, that's wonderful. Then you must be rather brilliant as well. At any rate, I hope that you'll think of me whenever you find yourself in need of traveling supplies. It's been a pleasure meeting you.
What do you have for sale?
Let's have a look, shall we? So nice of you to stop by.
That's it. I should tell Madame Twiddle about what happened. Mysterious and a bit unsettling. What to do?
Mrs. Twiddle, your husband was right. The statue was part of a puzzle.
Oh, really? How exciting!
Yes, I had to destroy a number of large vases, and that seemed to activate some sort of charm on the statue.
Well done! Oh, I miss having someone like you around with a thirst for knowledge and a quick mind. Well, my curiosity has been satisfied. Thank you for that. Who knows what I'll encounter on my next constitutional? Oh, my husband would be so pleased to know he was right about that statue.
Incendio! Ah. Confringo! Glacier! Defender! Expelliarmus! Accio! Expelliarmus! Incendio! Confringo!
An intruder! That student has taken our engagement to the tower!
What? Defender! Levioso!
No!
Incendio! Glacius! Protego! Confringo!
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Back from your latest flight? I want to hear all the particulars.
Good news, Mr. Weeks. With your upgrade, I was able to set a new record at the Irondale course.
Brilliant! I knew the upgrade had fantastic potential. How did your broom feel?
It rides well. Does get a tad shaky at top speed, and the handle wobbles a bit when I hit a strong gust of wind.
Ah, yes. I see. I think I know how to address that. Thank you. I owe you one.
If it means another upgrade, the pleasure's all mine.
You sound as determined as I am to improve broom flight. It's a joy to have a collaborator like yourself. If I'm right, and I do hope I am, you'll be hearing good news from me soon. Thank you again, truly.
Mr. Weeks and I do make a good team.
Revelio.
Mind now, Demi guys.
Revelio.
Welcome to the Ogg's Head. Any empty seat is yours.
Revelio. Revelio. Expelliarmus. Revelio. Revelio.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora.
Mine now, demiguys.
Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Alohomora. Revelio.
Hello, Miss Ryan. I wanted to thank you again for your help with Rookwood and Harlow the day of the troll attack.
Serona, please. And I was happy to help. Oh, those two are nothing but trouble. Glad you and your friend were here when they found you.
I am too. You were speaking to a goblin here that day.
Yes, Lodgok. He's a friend.
It seems as though you were on good terms with him.
I've known him for years. We met when I was waiting tables here as a student, well before I bought the place. He was cordial enough, but we weren't friends then. His mistrust of wizard kind ran deep.
But you're friends now?
We are. I hadn't seen him in years when he came in a few months ago. But he recognized me instantly, which is more than I can say for some of my own classmates. It took them a second to realize I was actually a witch, not a wizard. Not all goblins are like Ranrok and his loyalists. Lodgok is as worried as the rest of us about what's been going on.
In that case, I'd like to talk with him, about Ranrok in particular. Where might I find him?
I assume your interest is to do with the rumors I've heard about Ranrok working with our friend Rookwood.
It is.
If he's not here, you might find him doing business at the Hog's Head. He's a trusted metal trader. You should mention that we spoke. He can, understandably, be wary of witches and wizards, even ones as young as you. That said, if you're looking for information on Ranrok to help rein him in, you'll find an ally in Lodgok.
Have you heard what Ranrok and Rookwood are working on together?
Not much more than the fact that they seem to have some sort of uneasy alliance. Friendship between wizards and goblins is rare enough, but between those two, they each want something the other has. I can guarantee it. That said, I fear they're like a two-headed serpent. Both will need to be taken down to stop whatever scheme they've been plotting.
You seemed unfazed by Rookwood and Harlow the other day. They don't scare you.
They're bullies. Plain and simple. Never tolerated them in my own life, and certainly won't tolerate them going after my friends. Don't misunderstand me. They're dangerous wizards and shouldn't be trifled with. They should, however, be confronted and reminded, whenever possible, that the rest of us have each other's backs.
Thank you, Serona.
If you find Lodgok, please give him my best. I don't know what you've done to make such powerful enemies, but please, watch your back.
Thank you.
to see you outside the castle.
By myself, scurrying.
You too, Amit.
Don't be too careful. My father always taught me to keep my wand at the ready. Mind you, I was never the same.
You look familiar.
Hello, Lord Gok. Serona said I might find you here.
She did she? Did she send you with news?
No, actually, I wanted to speak with you. It's about Ranrok.
Now I remember. The three broomsticks. Day of the troll attack. You're the student he's after.
I am. And I need to know what he and his loyalists are up to, so I can stay a step ahead.
Let's say I did know. Why should I trust you?
Serona trusts me, and she thought our interests may be aligned.
Well, if Serona trusts you, very well. I may know of something that could help us both. A way to get Ranrok to confide his plans to me.
I'm listening.
Years ago, a heinous witch stole a sacred goblin relic. Rumor has it that it now rests in her sarcophagus, in a tomb accessible only by wizard kind. Ranrok and I had a falling out a while back. The relic could well repair the chasm between us.
Very well. I'll retrieve the relic if you promise to share Ranrok's plans with me.
We will have to trust each other. I, that you will not abscond with the relic, and you, that I'll share what I learn. Gather whatever supplies you may need and meet me near the witch's tomb.
Rebellion. I'm ready.
Good. There's no time to lose.
What precisely is the relic I'm to retrieve?
A valuable heirloom known as the Helmet of Urtgot. The witch considered herself a collector and purchased the helmet as a trinket. She cared not what pain she caused the goblins. Goblins believe that the rightful owner of any object is its maker, not its purchaser.
Wizard kind see things differently. It's a wonder goblins and wizards have ever been able to work together.
The differences between our kinds are myriad.
They seem to be.
It may surprise you to know that I do not believe those differences always to be insurmountable. It is the reason I find myself traveling with you to this tomb today.